no constitutional decision from this court is safe. That would be an intolerable state of affairs, and it cannot be the law.
Can I ask you about the implications of your position for other constitutional rights? The amicus brief of the Firearms Policy Coalition says, quote, this will easily become the model for suppression of other constitutional rights, with Second Amendment rights being the most likely targets, end quote. And it could be free speech rights, it could be free exercise of religion rights, it could be Second Amendment rights. If this position is accepted here, the theory of the amicus brief is that it can be easily replicated in other states that disfavor other constitutional rights. Your response?
Your Honor, in several of those circumstances, individuals were concerned that a lack of immediate pre-enforcement federal court access would cause them ruinous liability or otherwise suppress their ability to exercise those rights, have turned to Congress and succeeded.
For some of those examples, I think it would be quite difficult to get legislation through Congress. Are you saying, absent that, that Second Amendment rights, free exercise of religion rights, free speech rights could be targeted by other states?
My answer is on whether or not federal court review is available does not turn on the nature of the right. We have to assume that other state courts' judges are in fact going to faithfully apply the Constitution, its rights, and this court's decisions.
So this is not limited to abortion. That's the point that's been raised. It's limited to any law that a state thinks is dissatisfied with.
Your Honor, I've at no point in the earlier argument or this one asserted that the extent of federal courts or federal court availability turns on the underlying right here. Quite the opposite.
So
I agree with you.
So your point is that no matter how much a state intends to chill the exercise of a constitutional right, that does not give anyone a right to a federal forum when the state has deputized every citizen to act on its behalf.
No, Your Honor, it does not create federal jurisdiction as a consequence.
If that's right, you know, and we say that, we would live in a very different world from the world we live in today. Essentially, we would be inviting states, all 50 of them, with respect to their unpreferred constitutional rights, to try to nullify the law of that this court has laid down as to the content of those rights. I mean, that was something that until this law came along, no state dreamed of doing. And essentially, we would be like, you're open for business. There's nothing the Supreme Court can do about it. Guns, same-sex marriage, religious rights, whatever you don't like, go ahead.
The state of Texas hasn't nullified anything.